everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Two running backs will take the field today in hopes of leading their team to victory out on that field. It's the Titans going up against the Chiefs. With that, we'll get you out to one of the livelier settings in the NFL, Arrowhead Stadium in KC, as we say hello to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Tennessee Titans and the Kansas City Chiefs. Hi again, everyone. I'm Brandon Godden. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. With me, as always, Charles Davis. And, Charles, we look at a matchup like this. It's really the running backs that may take center stage here today.
And in today's football, they're still valuable, not just as runners, but guys who can catch the ball as well. It's really the number of touches that determines things these days.
Ryan Succop, the man tasked with getting this one started. And we are underway from Arrowhead. Tyreek Hill on the return. He'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. And Alex Smith leading Kansas City onto the field, coming off an exciting win over the Falcons, 29-28. And Alex Smith performed admirably, 21-25, 270 and a touchdown.
It almost felt like Alex Smith was announcing to the rest of the NFL and all of his critics out there, oh, yeah, I can push the ball downfield when I want to. And when I do it very well. He had a big game against Atlanta. Didn't hurt that Desmond Trufant, Atlanta's corner, wasn't playing in the game. He's on IR.
It's the Princeton man. This is Spencer Ware. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. This is the offense we're going to see coming up in this one, and Travis Kelce will be key.
What a tremendous weapon he is, especially in the red zone. Knows how to find the end zone when running his routes.
Second down, here's Smith. The tight end Kelce has it over the middle. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. And Travis Kelce's been looking good. Back-to-back 100-yard games. Had 140 on eight catches last week.
You know, we talk about people rounding in the form. I think it's much more the public finally becoming aware of just what a weapon this guy is, what a talent he is. He can detach him from the line of scrimmage. He gets downfield into the secondary. Can make the short catch turn into a big game. He can also run past people and catch the deep ball down the middle as well. I think he's a heck of a player. And his Sunday, a little bit better than his brother Jason's, who was in Philadelphia struggling against Cincinnati.
So not much to speak of scoring-wise in this first quarter of play. Nothing, nothing, our score. EA Sports NFL Sunday returns following this.
The NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Head & Shoulders. Shoulders were made for greatness, not dandruff.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Godden. As the Chiefs in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter. And they've got it here with a first down. Smith. It's complete to Chris Conley. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. So here we go, first and 10 now. On the Now a first down throw. It's Smith. It's Hill. Complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. Three yards to go on second down. To the air again, Smith. Looking left side, that's caught by Macklin. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
So the offense has it first and 10. Smith throwing again. He's got time. Wide open receiver complete. And he carries this one all the way down to the 9. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And welcome back. The offensive unit, they took the timeout. And now they get set to line up as we resume action. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Again, Smith. He hits West underneath. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. Call it a pickup of 7, and that'll make it second and goal. So plenty of action on the field, but no action right now on the scoreboard, at least as of yet. Nothing is our score. As we send you down to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando, where we find our man Larry Ridley with our halftime report.
Thanks, Brandon. I'm Larry Ridley, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. It's a 0-0 game at half, so both sides obviously love their defense and hate their offense. Moving forward, we'll just have to see if it's the first to score that wins. So let's take a look at the highlights from the first half. Chiefs open up on offense. Smith finding his mark across the middle of the field, and that connection will lead to a gain of 9 yards. Chiefs later on the drive, Conley's gonna make the catch in traffic, and the pass and catch will end up going for 11 yards. Continuing on the drive, the pass will be completed into coverage, and it's going to end up going for a gain of 7. Sticking with the same drive, Smith's going to complete the pass from the gun, and that connection will lead to a gain of 29 yards.
Thank you, Mr. Ridley. A scoreless first half, and now we're set for quarter number 3. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. Fielded about a yard deep. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. second half starts with a run by Murray. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Again, it's Murray. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. So 3 quarters in the book, still no one on the scoreboard. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. We're back now in KC as we are just about set to go here in quarter number four. Well, time not on their side here. In fact, a lot going against them. They do have a small glimmer of hope.
No one likes to play extra football. They want to go for the win right now.
Mariota throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. Four yards remaining now on second down. Here's Mariota. And that's incomplete. He was looking for DeMarco Murray out of the backfield. And it's third and four. Surveying the field. Great protection. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now here's a defensive timeout called by the Chiefs. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. Here's Brett Kern now as he's on to punt for Tennessee. He'll send this one into the Midwestern air, and it's a good one. And great special teams work here. This is knocking on the door of the five. They'll spot it at the 6-yard line. We focus our attention on the Titans defense now. And as we're going to see right here, they have been laying some pretty electrifying hits in this one.
And these are for real. Okay, as you watch, think about putting yourself in that spot, about being the ball carrier or the receiver.
I don't want to.
And then taking that shot, it is something else. It's not like when we were watching that video clip where they showed you how they make sounds for movies. This is for real.
Get up. And not great starting field position here for the offense. The run, it's Ware, and he's going to be taken down here at about the 10. A gain of 3, second down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They'll come out in the pistol. And we need overtime to decide this one after four quarters of play. We're all even. The extra session in a moment. This is the NFL on EA Sports. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
Nothing between these two teams for four quarters. Here we go to begin overtime. This fielded at the 2. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. So now here are the Chiefs as their offense makes their way back out onto the field. Smith, they complete it to Hill, and they're able to get this one across the 35. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll be down to just one remaining as we step aside here in overtime. This is Ware, and some room to maneuver, and able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. On the play back at the 45-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It'll be their third and final stoppage here in overtime, and we'll be back. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. Smith now on second down. Oh, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. A costly mistake here in OT.
And you know what they say when you throw an interception like that in overtime? You don't usually get a chance to throw a second one. I mean, I'm not sure the analytics on it. Let's ask Marvin, our statistician, to ring that down for us. That's typically how coaches and teams feel about it. If you throw one, you likely cost yourself the game.
First throw in overtime for Mariota. Finding time. And he will be hit from behind and run over. Wow. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. Offense needs something here on second down. It is second and long. Murray, the lone setback. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that will be their third and final in this overtime session. And as they talk it over, we take a break. We'll be right back. And we are back here. I'm Brandon Gaughan alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes the timeout. And now we're set to get going. DB here for the Chiefs on third down.
Pass situation.
Mariota, he dumps it off for Henry. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. So a full four quarters and the extra session, not a single point scored. How about both of these defenses in this one?
I mean, just look at my face.
You're smiling.
What am I feeling right now?
Jubilation.
Jubilation, pride. Defense is still in the game. Look, no one's going to go home happy, because there is not a winner. And we don't get an extra period to play because we're in regular season. But bottom line, that's football. That's football to me.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL on EA.